It's Andre from the High Performance Academy. I'm here with Yannis from Plex Tuning to talk about their knock monitor. Now, knock or detonation is one of the most destructive parts of tuning an engine. It will destroy your engine in literally seconds. So monitoring that knock and making sure it's not occurring is critical to the tuning process. So Yannis, there's obviously a lot of products out there already for monitoring knock and detonation. What sets your product apart from the opposition?
It combines features that you cannot find on any other product, and it offers an easy way to get repeatable and accurate knock measurements.
Let's start by talking about those features that separate it. I mean, most of the knock systems that I'm familiar with, most of the ones that are on the market are audio only. So they're taking the input from a physical donut-style piezoelectric knock sensor, maybe running it through some digital signal processing and amplifying it, then sending it out to a headset. Your system's quite unique in that you've got a lot more going on there than just the audio. Can you tell us about that?
Yes, we also can connect a trigger signal to the system, so it can know the engine RPM and set a variable threshold for the knock detection to vary with the engine RPM and do per cylinder knock detection.
So in terms of getting that RPM signal in, obviously that background noise level that's occurring, you know, the knock sensor isn't just picking up detonation or knock, it's also measuring the background engine vibration or noise signal. And that noise signal will increase as the engine RPM increases. That's correct?
Yes, that's correct. You need to have a variable threshold for knock detection because the engine noise will increase with RPM. And if your threshold is fixed, you will either get false detection at high RPM if it's too low, or you will not get efficient detection at low RPM if it is too high.
So with this knock threshold that you can set up using the knock monitor, can you explain to me how we'd go about configuring that knock threshold so that we know where it should be set to properly detect detonation?
It's quite easy. You set up the engine for testing and you have to do one dyno pull or run with the engine using safe ignition settings. Also at the same time verifying through the headphones that the engine is not detonating. The instrument will record this base engine noise profile, and then you can set your threshold line just above this recorded noise level.
So you're basically getting a known engine noise profile versus RPM that you know that no detonation is occurring, and then anything above that is considered knock or detonation?
Yes, and you can set two levels for, let's say, a low-intensity knock and high-intensity knock, so you can have two different alarms, two LEDs light up, so that you can, let's say, pay more attention to the more serious events and maybe go on if you have small events.
Now, talking about that noise threshold, my own experience has been, let's say we've got a turbocharged car, that background noise with no knock present at, say, low boost pressure, maybe 1 bar of boost, versus what we could expect to see at maybe 3 bar of boost, that would be different. So how would you accommodate that?
That might be different, but if you're tuning on a dyno and you're slowly going up in boost, it's easy to accommodate for. You just have to raise your threshold line a little. It doesn't change much.
Okay, so you would actually raise it as you increase the boost?
You might have to raise it a little, yes.
Okay, now every engine's obviously different. You've got different cylinder block materials. You've got different bore diameters, and that can affect the frequency, the center frequency that knock's occurring at. How does your knock monitor account for that?
Yes, it has a built-in calculator for knock frequency versus bore size. This will get you in the ballpark. It will be good enough. And since the input filters are not very narrow, in almost all cases, you will not need to do anything to change that base frequency. You can also set the audio output frequency at this same frequency or at another harmonic so that you can better distinguish knock from the mechanical engine noise.
So just for those out there watching this who don't understand what we're talking about there, the knock frequency is quite a specific frequency, and by using a filter to focus solely or around that frequency, that helps reduce that background noise and gives you more accurate detection of detonation?
That's correct. That's the way it is done in the instrument with a DSP processor that filters the input signal according to the frequency that you set it.
Okay, so for someone like myself who's used to using audio knock detection, you've still got that ability, you can still plug a headset into the knock monitor?
Yes, I think it's essential to have audio as well, and so that it's easy to verify that you have actual knock by hearing it and also seeing what's happening on the screen. And then the more that you use the instrument, the more confidence that you'll have that it will supply the correct information for your tuning.
Have we got any ability, once you've actually got this set up and it's functioning well, have you got the ability to then feed the output, the knock data or knock threshold, out into an external logging system or into an ECU?
Yes, we have two analog outputs. One indicates the knock level and the other one indicates the knock count. You can connect this to any dynamometer or data logger 0 to 5 volt input. And there is even an output that you can set up as to have a knock retard function. So you can set it up and connect it to an ECU and set up the ECU to retard timing when this input goes up in voltage, and it will work as a basic knock retard mechanism for the ECU.
Look, it certainly seems like you've thought of everything and covered all of your bases. It's a very well thought out product with a huge amount of features, but it still seems like it is relatively easy for the end user to configure. Is that fair to say?
It is easy, and we have two presets that allow you to go into actual knock detection in three steps. You can use this at the beginning, and then as you get familiar with the capabilities of the device, go into the full menu and adjust settings more. So the two presets allow you into three button clicks, and you are detecting knock.
Look, from my perspective, knock detection is an essential part of tuning. This product certainly covers some bases that I haven't personally seen before. Thanks for bringing this to the market. It is a great product, and thank you for taking the time to chat to us today.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
For online tuning courses, visit learntotune.com.